deception, psychosis, shattered hearts, murder. This is the story of Hamlet, a killer and a victim. The E, true Hollywood story.
The dream of the
from life's ambition was to be
our story begins in the small town of Akron. Hamlet, a poor businessman, clawed his way up the corporate ladder with vigor and honorable intentions. He and his wife, Gertrude, had just given birth to their first son, whom they named Hamlet Jr. The family lived a happy and prosperous life as young Hamlet grew into a deeply intellectual and emotional boy. He was often troubled by life's most challenging problems and unfortunately turned to drinking at a young age. Hamlet loved both his mother and his father very much, though he had a strained relationship with his uncle Claudius, as he sensed his mother's closeness to him.
Just when everything was going well, devastation struck. Hamlet Sr. was found dead in his brother's kitchen. The death of his father launched Hamlet into a downward spiral that would eventually lead to his own demise.
Biographer Bill Shakespeare.
During the first few years of New Hamlet, he seemed like your average kid. He fit in well, he had a lot of friends, he got good grades. It wasn't until his dad died that he really went downhill. He really changed after his father died.
Hamlet's close personal friend, Horatia.
Hamlet and I had a good childhood. We hung out all the time, had fun, just like normal kids. And then his dad died. Supposedly he had a heart attack, but Hamlet didn't believe that was true. And I'd ask him what happened, but he just, by that time he was in his own little world, you know? And he dressed in black all the time and just moped around everywhere he went. And I remember him telling me this one time about him being on the internet, and he was just playing some game or I don't know, whatever he was doing. And he got a message. He said it was from his dad, but dad was dead. It didn't make any sense. I don't know. I didn't really believe him at the time. Started to happen.
Hamlet began to sense the presence of his father in strange ways. He became convinced that his only objective in life was to avenge the untimely death.
After Hamlet got those messages from his father, he never really trusted anyone again. He was always rethinking his relationship with everybody. Horatia was the only person that he really trusted anymore.
Hamlet changed a lot after his father's death. He was always on edge. He was always, I might even go so far as to say he was kind of crazy. I didn't know him anymore. And after the Polonius incident, we all knew that things just wouldn't ever be the same.
Hamlet became obsessed with his mission. He allowed it to saturate his thoughts to the point of lunacy.
Polonius had hidden to avoid Hamlet's violent temper. Hamlet came home to find his mother was not alone. Believing Claudius was in the house, Hamlet suddenly became filled with the need to slaughter his father's assassin. Suddenly, Polonius's phone rang. Hearing it, Hamlet dashed down the hall, blind with rage. Unbeknownst to Hamlet, however, the man who hid in the shower was not Claudius, but in fact his most trusted advisor, Polonius. Chief Investigator Melissa Everett.
I arrived at the crime scene of Polonius' death about an hour after it happened. We found Polonius laying face up in the bathtub of Hamlet's house, and Hamlet and Gertrude were the only two present at the scene, and currently they are the leading suspects for this murder.
Hamlet was sent to Akron's Juvenile Correction Facility for a brief stay before his bail was posted by Gertrude. Polonius was survived by his son Laertes and his daughter Ophelia. Ophelia was unable to come to grips with the fact that her father had been slain at the hands of a former lover. Laertes, on the other hand, became consumed with fury and vengeance. He and Claudius began to conspire against Hamlet.
After Polonius' death, Ophelia lost all feelings for anyone who was close to her. Her and Hamlet were actually supposed to get married and live together and be happy. But after she found out that he killed her father, she just decided to end it.
When Ophelia heard the news about Polonius, she went crazy. She went around and she was singing songs that didn't make any sense, and she had this look in her eyes. It was insane. I'd never seen anything like it. And then, I guess she just couldn't take it anymore.
A few weeks ago, I got a call from Gertrude, and she was in a complete state of shock. She told me that she had found Ophelia dead at the Christ United Methodist Church. I hurried over, and I found her lying on the altar with a gunshot wound to her temple. She was, in fact, dead, and it was proclaimed that she had committed suicide.
Ophelia's best friend, Sarah Jacobs.
Ophelia and I are best friends from church. We've known each other for a really, really long time. We're all really upset to hear about her death, that she killed herself in our church. She'd always, acted really crazy. She was always really depressed. I guess it was inevitable that she would commit suicide.
I remember the day. I was just sitting at home, minding my own business, and I got a call, and it was Hamlet. He wanted me to come over and play some Texas Hold'em and have a good time, and I thought that was cool. And then I got there, and I saw who else he'd invited.
A few days after Ophelia's death, I received a telephone call from Horatia telling me that there had been an accident within the Hamlet household. When I arrived at the scene, I found that Gertrude and Hamlet had been poisoned to death. Laertes had died from a stab wound to the back, and Claudius had died from a gunshot wound to the stomach. So far, this is all the information that we have. We are trying to find more evidence and interviews to determine how this all could have come about.
Everything happened so fast that night. I still can't remember all the details, but it was the worst night of my life. All I can really remember is going up to him and touching his hand. And I told him, "Good night, sweet prince." And all he said was, "The rest is silence." And it was over.
From the time Hamlet's father died until his own death, he was isolated and lonely, doomed to a life without happiness. He experienced a roller coaster of emotions that no one had anticipated. His death had made widespread headlines, but hit hardest in the town he called home. Hamlet was a legend in his own time, and his memory will live on.